Well, fewer than 120 hours remain before the polls close in the 2018 midterm elections. We are counting. It's getting zany out there. In one state, Democrats are trying to discourage hunters from voting. In another, the pro-abortion lobby is telling us that abortion is good for kids. To help investigate these stories in several midterm races, Lisa Boothe, the Independent Woman's Voice, is back with us, as she has been most nights for
a long time.
Great to see you, Lisa. So
good to see you. Sometimes I can't believe some of this stuff is real, but
it always gets crazier as we get closer. Hunters shouldn't vote. Tell me about this story.
Right. So as you know, North Dakota is Republicans' best pickup opportunity this election cycle for the Senate. The Republican there, Kevin Cramer, has been up about 11.4%. in the Real Clear Politics average. So it looks like the Democrat Party is trying to pull out all the stops to make up some ground. So they have been running ads on Facebook saying Hunter Alert. And basically what these ads are telling voters is that if you vote this election cycle, you may lose your out-of-state hunting license. And if you click on these ads, they basically take you to either the Democrat Party's website that is essentially reiterating the same thing, or a landing page on Facebook that just has the logos. And why this is important, the Department of Game and Fishing, they've reached out to them, and they've essentially said that they have no idea what the Democrat Party of North Dakota is talking about. The Secretary of State has said the same thing. And Heidi Heitkamp had actually transferred almost $3 million to the Democrat Party of North Dakota. So she had maybe partially paid for these ads. And the State Party of North Dakota for the Republicans are criticizing Democrats, obviously, for voter suppression. So they've been under a lot of fire for these ads.
Pretty hard to intimidate voters, I mean, hunters. How great that they're a meaningful constituency in the state. So tell me, of all the Orwellian things I've heard recently, and I've heard a lot, war is peace, love is hate, I mean, you hear it every day, but abortion is good for kids. This is the case that the official abortion lobby, the industry lobby, NARAL, is now making?
Yeah, so that's what they're making. So essentially what they did is they sent out this tweet saying the research is clear. Restricting abortion access doesn't just hurt women. It also hurts kids. And what they do is link to an LA Times report about a research done from a demographer out of the University of California, San Francisco. And the argument that this woman is making in her research is that 60% of women have children that have abortions, and one third of them have abortions because of the children that they already have. So somehow the children they already have are going to end up in poverty or be disadvantaged if this woman is not allowed an abortion.
If they have siblings.
My reminder to them, or my message to them, would be, you know, maybe if they want to help children, they should get out of the abortion business.
No, it's one of those studies like, no, carjacking helps drivers. No, it really does. It's just you're not smart enough to understand how. Lisa, thank you.
Thank you, Tucker.
Great to see you tonight. Dana Perino hosts the Daily Briefing. She's on the 5 every night, one of our favorite people, and always flies at 35,000 feet and is the person we go to for the overview. So what is this series of races? Not one election, obviously, it's many elections. But what are the main themes on both sides as of tonight, would you say?
Well, I would say the closing arguments, if you really just had to boil it down, you saw President Trump today in the Roosevelt Room, and that, I think, chosen that site for a very specific reason. He was wanting to give a policy-specific speech, not a rally. He wanted to talk about immigration. So that is what he has decided is going to be his closing argument going into Tuesday. Democrats, on the other hand, are talking about health care, and it could help them win back the House because, you know, the Republicans ran on it in 2010, 2012, 2014, 2016. They won it all. And they didn't deliver on what they said they would do. I think the Republicans have missed an opportunity to talk more about health care because, believe me, the Democrats are not just going to talk about it in 2018. This is going to be a major topic in 2020. Their policy, Medicare for All, not that popular. In a popular vote, however, if you ask people they want single-payer health care, Obamacare more popular today than it was at any other time previously. We have a serious problem in this country. We could have two conversations, one about immigration and one about health care, but we better start having them quickly.
People are terrified by the cost of their health care. And, you know, we can debate the solutions, but if you ignore that, I agree with you. I agree with you completely.
Because they think about it personally. Like, it is true. Chuck Blahouse over at the Mercatus Center, he did the study, $32 trillion to pay for Medicare for All. That's a huge number, and Republicans keep driving that home. But you know what? If you're an individual, you're a family member, you're thinking, well, $32 trillion, you can't get your head around that. But I do know that if I get sick, maybe my business doesn't help me pay for health care. What if I end up going bankrupt because of my medical bills. That stuff is very real. And I think the Democrats knew that from the beginning, and they have singularly focused on that. They will not talk about border security. They are focused on health care 100% to the Republicans' detriment.
So do you think, I mean, look, I personally think, speaking for myself as a non-economist, that Medicare for All is insane and it won't work. However, I also watch the Republicans who seem duty-bound to defend insurance companies and drug companies, and I'm wondering, how long is that going to last? Will you see Republicans like strike a middle ground? Like, you don't have to toe the line of the insurance companies.
It's possible, but you know, President Trump last week, the administration put forward this idea of having the government basically put price controls on pharmaceutical drugs.
That's right.
Lots of European countries do that. I think it's a terrible idea, and I think you'll see conservatives say, "Wait, we're not actually for that because it hasn't worked elsewhere." But it sounds good, right? It's quite popular. And maybe they'll be able to make that case. Let's just say that the Democrats take back the House. Is Nancy Pelosi going to pass on an opportunity to put price controls on pharmaceutical drugs if President Trump is offering that? I mean, that would be quite remarkable if she doesn't want to do that. Just like, would they pass on the ability to give amnesty to the Dreamers and for a little bit of border security? I mean, I think Americans want some sort of compromise. But I got to tell you, Tucker, between 2018 and 2020, if both sides go into this closing argument on immigration and health care, and they both do okay, the Republicans keep the Senate, the Democrats take the House, what do you think people are going to run on in 2020?
Probably Trump.
The same thing. No, it'll be the same thing. It'll
be
more
of
the same, because nothing will get solved. It'll be immigration and health care. And also
Dana Perino, great to see you. Thank you for that
grim
window into the future.